Hey guys, this is Nathan Asher, and I'd like to dedicate this video to Ryan Daniel's Bible Study Group. It's an absolute blessing that you guys have been switched on to me, and I hope that we can make many more videos like this for many days to come. So until then, thank you so much, Ryan. God bless you to his Bible Study Group, and let's get into it. Now, I'm in Mexico City. I've been in Mexico City for just over a year now. But do you know that statistics said that before COVID hit, almost 50% of the Mexican population had reached poverty levels? But now, coming up to 1 year into the COVID crisis, the numbers here in Mexico have skyrocketed up past 75, even 80% poverty levels. Whole families are out of work. Fathers that have lost their jobs are now designated to intersections where every red light they have to wash windows for spare change. I see dads having to park cars now for spare change. You see mothers taking their young sons and daughters around selling commissaries just to get by. And even me, I've been out of work for over 1 year now because of COVID, but it's kind of hard to feel down and out about myself when I see the struggle of those around me.
No hay trabajo ahorita por el COVID, por eso no tengo trabajo, estoy limpiando carros.
Pues sí, nos afectó bastante y que no podemos trabajar.
El impacto ha sido bastante duro, tanto emocionalmente como psicológicamente.
Quiero, la verdad, quiero salir adelante, pero no se puede. Es que ando a la calle nada más ganando unas monedas, aunque nada más sea un taco.
Nosotros dependemos del comercio y de la economía de la gente.
1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 16 to 18 says, to rejoice always, giving thanks in all circumstances. The Bible says to rejoice always in all circumstances. Jesus himself said in Matthew chapter 5, verse 45, that God sends the sun to shine on the good and on the evil alike, and sends his rain to pour down on the righteous and the unrighteous. So what this means is that when the sun shines in your world, rejoice. And even when the rain pours, rejoice.
Yo ni robo, nada de cero, nada de vicio, y nada de droga. Yo ando bien limpio aquí trabajando.
Porque sí hay problemas para trabajar y estar laborando luego con la policía o así la gente se nos...
La situación de que casi no hemos podido vender, está un poco complicada, los gastos en las casas.
Aunque no me dejas limpiar su coche, pues aunque sea unas monedas me regala. Eso es todo lo que yo digo.
Paul says in Ephesians 4 verses 12 to 13 that he knows how to be brought low and he knows how to abound. That in any and every circumstance, Paul has learnt the secret of facing plenty and hunger, abundance and need, that he can do all things through Christ that strengthens him. And you might be asking the question, Nathan, how? And that's a good question. Because for many, this feels impossible. After all, how do we rejoice through all, in every circumstance, in any situation? Yes. And Paul says that there's a secret. The Bible says to give thanks in all circumstances. So here's the key. In all circumstances, give thanks. Thankfulness is not just a state of mind, but it's a state of being. It's not just a disposition as much as it is an expression. Thankfulness is an action that through all circumstances, give in thankfulness. Rejoice always by being a person that gives even when his sun comes up or her rain comes down. That through any and everything, Paul says that he has learnt the secret, and this secret is the action of giving through all circumstances.
Bueno, agradecido, pues estoy con Dios porque afortunadamente nos hemos mantenido dentro de lo que cabe sanos. No hemos tenido ninguna complicación con esta pandemia. Agradecido con la vida porque me da la oportunidad de tener todos mis órganos completos para seguir trabajando. Y siempre he pensado que a pesar de lo duro de la vida, mientras tengamos salud, teniendo salud, pues puede uno salir a trabajar, se puede uno mover y puede uno ver por la familia, ¿no?
Paul says that this is the secret to being faced with plenty and being faced with hunger. that this is how he learnt to be brought low and to abound, is to give in thanks through any and every circumstance. And for many, including myself, it almost feels like an impossible feat. And it's true. For many non-born again people, this is an impossible task because it displays an attitude of selflessness. When you are in the world, we are overcome with a sense of selfishness that we gravitate inwards. But when you come to Jesus, when you have a renewed walk with Christ, and when you are born again, received sons and daughters into the kingdom, instead of gravitating inwards to self-pleasure, to self-seeking, and to self-gain, Jesus reverses that narrative and he makes you others focused. He makes you gravitate outwards towards other people to be a blessing for others. That no matter where life finds you, no matter your circumstances, and no matter what you're faced with, to give. And here is where it's so powerful. That we may feel that the action of giving is for the primary benefit of those who receive. But that's not true. Because the action of giving, while it does impact those who receive, the primary benefit is for those who give. And the age-old idiom is true, that it's more blessed to give than to receive.
Aquí se está trabajando bien, pues la verdad a mí me gusta ese trabajo de la calle. Pues la verdad yo sí respeto a la gente en los coches y me gusta trabajar mucho ese trabajo.
¿Un papá?
¿Por tu papá?
Okay. ¿Su familia? Yo estoy agradecido porque tengo salud, tengo donde vivir, gracias a Dios, y porque no me hace falta un plato de comida caliente.
Pues también estoy agradecido, ya que gracias a Dios, a pesar de las circunstancias, seguimos saliendo adelante y echándole ganas.
En eso es en lo que yo te puedo decir que estoy muy agradecido con la vida.
Gracias, muchas gracias.
Difícil para todos, la situación no está nada agradable, pero echamos adelante, dando gracias a Dios de que vivimos en él.
2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 15 to 16 says, speaking of the act of thanksgiving, says that it is all for your sake, that as grace extends more and more to those around you, it increases you with thanksgiving. And that though your outer self might be wasting away, your inner self is renewed day by day. So in other words, God is saying that giving with thanks is for the primary benefit of your sake. That as the act of grace coming from you extends more and more to those around you, it will increase you with the spirit of thanksgiving. It might impact the flesh, but it renews the heart. Though it might impact your bank statement, it renews your state. It might empty the stomach, but it fills the soul. And though it might hurt your circumstances, it heals your spirit. So are you looking to be a person of gratitude? Are you looking to be a Christian filled with more thankfulness? Paul says that the secret is to give with thanks always, through all, in any and every circumstance. And I want you to notice just exactly what you can expect of this kind of gratitude. Colossians chapter 3 verse 15 says that the result of thankfulness means that the peace of Christ will rule in your heart. And let me assure you that you'll never be left without. Psalms chapter 103 verse 3 to 5 reminds us not to forget all of God's benefits, that he forgives all our iniquities, and that he heals all our disease, that he redeems our lives and satisfies us with good so that we are renewed. You know, sometimes God comes along and forces us to adjust and to reinterpret for ourselves what exactly it means to be blessed, what it means to have, and what it really means to prosper. A lot of the time we contextualize these things to mean something along the lines of personal gain or material wealth. But are those things truly what it means for the Bible when it talks about blessings, when it talks about being prosperous and what it truly means to have? Or is to be blessed more along the lines of a secure relationship with God? Prosperous more along the lines of growing in grace? And does to have mean more about obtaining a personal spot for yourself in the kingdom? more than it means procuring personal wealth and possessions in this world. Okay, until next time, it's Nathan Asher. To Daniel and his Bible study group, I hope that this video can help you in your walk with gratitude and thankfulness. May God bless you and may God rest you. I'll see you next time.